Science is always evolving. Much has been discovered, but health research that integrates age, sex, gender, and race can provide new insights. For example, pain hypersensitivity is mediated by microglial cells in male mice, but a different type of immune cell, likely T cells, creates the same effect in females. And clinical scientists have recently found that patients with a higher feminine gender score have a greater risk of recurring heart disease, independent of their biological sex. Peer review provides a critical opportunity to raise the bar for scientific excellence and new discoveries. That's why successful grant proposals must adhere to the highest standards of rigor, reproducibility, transparency, and inclusion in science. But when and how should sex and gender be included in proposals? Let's start with sex, which refers to the biological attributes of cells, tissues, animals, and humans. Many cell types show sex differences, including stem cells, immune cells, cardiac and lung cells, and brain and muscle cells. But there are some cases where sex may not be relevant. Examples might include the study of the structural or molecular biology of proteins, carbohydrates, or lipids, pathogens grown in vitro in an acellular environment, or the preclinical design of some biomedical technologies. However, applicants who exclude sex from the research design must always provide compelling justifications. When sex is applicable, a strong proposal that effectively integrates sex as a biological variable will include male and female cells, tissues, animals, or humans, report and analyze the sex of cells, tissues, animals, or humans, design experiments that disaggregate results by sex, build on what we know about sex differences in the field of study. A weak application that does not effectively integrate sex fails to provide compelling justification for a single-sex study, ignores sex differences reported in the scientific literature, or fails to build on published data, does not report the sex of the cells, tissues, animals, or humans, fails to describe a sex disaggregation in the analysis plan, conflates and/or confuses the terms sex and gender. Now, let's look at gender, which refers to the socially constructed roles, behaviors, expressions, and identities of girls, women, boys, men, and gender-diverse people. Gender needs to be integrated as a social determinant of health for clinical, health systems, and population health research. And both sex and gender should be considered in human and database studies whenever possible. But there are some cases where gender may not be relevant. Examples might include some clinical studies of disease processes and treatments, certain single-sex studies that use existing data sets, or secondary data analyses where it's impossible to create a gender variable. Remember, applicants who don't integrate gender must justify why it's not possible or relevant. When it is applicable, a strong research proposal that effectively integrates gender will report what is known about gender, describe how gender will be measured or investigated, use recruitment methods that address and mitigate bias, design experiments that disaggregate and analyze results by gender, develop a knowledge translation plan that considers gender. A weak research proposal that does not effectively integrate gender fails to report that gender is relevant to the topic, ignores gender differences reported in the scientific literature, or fails to build on published data, fails to measure or disaggregate results by gender when possible or relevant, conflates and/or confuses the terms sex and gender. These are the basics. You can find detailed resources on the Canadian Institutes of Health Research website. Integrating sex and gender ensures the scientific research we fund is rigorous, reproducible, inclusive, and meets the highest international standards of excellence. It sparks innovation and can help us tackle big health challenges. Science is better with sex and gender.